hope you enjoy today's message on Acts chapter 2 verse 38 preaching channel. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, and hit the bell to help us grow.
Give us come to a place with other concerns in your heart and life. You didn't really feel good about the Lord knowing about it. You didn't even want to open that place up. You didn't even want to look at it yourself. You didn't want anybody bothering it. You didn't want messages from the pulpit preached about it. You didn't want anybody saying anything about it. You don't want anybody digging around there, knocking on that door. You don't want that. Was there ever a time when that was the case with you? I guarantee if each of us is honest, everybody in this building would say amen to that. If there comes a time, it's real with us. Oh, Lord. open up that area of my life. I'm going to give you the key and open the door. And we're going to talk about that. We're going to deal with that. We're going to look at that. We're going to wash that away. Calvary's flow. It's going to be a part of the past. And you get free from that. And the fear leaves you. And you can say, Lord, in the hallway, in the room, in the cellar of my heart, wherever you want to go, you're welcome. And bear it all to Jesus. We ought not to have anything if we minister to others here in our heart. We ought not to have any room where the Lord's not welcome. We ought not to have an area that we are afraid to deal with. We ought to be acquainted with the altar. Brother Cole said it well the other day at Brother Kilgore's. We borrowed altars from the Methodists. Maybe that's not the place where sinners ought to go to receive the Holy Ghost. The theology of all of that doesn't make a lot of difference. I've seen them get the Holy Ghost beside the road in a ditch somewhere. They just got out of the car and dropped down beside the road, and God filled them with the Holy Ghost. And that man that did that preaching today, another man got down under the sawmill where he was working, down there under the basement of that old building, and he got to praying, and God filled him with the Holy Ghost there. You can get the Holy Ghost anywhere. But those altars, you and I need from time to time. We need that altar. We need to go back and pray a little while and talk to God about some things in our heart that build up in there. So much contact with the world and jobs and people and family back home that are not sympathetic, and things and money and finances and problems. Our lives get filled with that thing, those things sometimes. And slowly and surely I walk with God. He rolls and I faith, He rolls. And we just need that altar. We need that place to pray. We need the messages that come from the pulpit. We need the strong preaching, and we need the Word of God to dig around every old black patch in our lives and knock on every roof in our hearts. Amen. I need that. I need that. I need that. I need preaching. I need somebody to look me right in the eye and say, hey, you need to shape up. You need to pay through. You need to do right. You need to quit thinking like you're thinking. You need a new attitude. What they do in these pastors' institutes, and we talk to each other, and they talk to each other. Brother Harley, Brother Anderson minister to us, and they need accountability too. Every one of them, there's not a one of us that would not need accountability to somebody. I need to be accountable. I need that. We're all accountable to the Lord, but we need accountability to each other too. I saw the Lord bring Sister Glenda a long way in just the short years that I've known. I appreciate it. I love that song, and I think every one of us can relate to it. I want to sing another verse and put it over to them.
All through my life, I could tell you, back in the beginning, we woke up to a super church down stand, but I'll tell you the latest. We were having services at Church Up in Cornell, and Brother Waddell's preaching, something got a hold of my heart, and I started crying out to God, and he was talking, go through that door, go through that door. I said, Lord, hey, God, I won't be hurt again. I can't handle this. Don't hurt me again. And I ran to go through that door, and after I finished crying, I told God, no, I'm still not willing to go through it, God. But I'm willing to carry the trip on the cross of my pastor and his wife up here. I'm willing to help them out. And the Lord let an instance happen. He moved me in their home. He taught me things, and now I got to leave again. And God gave me the second chance. He said, okay, are you going to go through the door now? And now I am, because God's taken me, He's helped me, He's walked with me along the way, and I thank Him for that. I open up that door, make it through the door. I need more, no one.
Here we are at the end of the quarter now, and I wonder, are you growing? Have you grown? Don't just close your eyes a few moments, thinking back over the last 3 months. Do you know more about the Lord than you knew when you know in September? Are you closer in your relationship to each other? Do you understand principles of the Word of God a little more than you did? Are you growing? Is it easier for you to say I'm sorry than it used to be? It is, you're growing. Is it easier to say forgive me? Would it be easier to wash your brother's feet, your sister's feet than it was 3 months ago than it would have been then? Are you learning to look at yourself with reality and truth and real honesty? If you are, you're growing. Praise God. If you're a man enough and woman enough to tell your brother or sister, I'm sorry, forgive me. The Lord put some things in my heart that make me want to realize I need to do this. I want you to forgive me. I want to grow in Him, and I want to mature in Christ. I want to be what He has me to be. Praise God. I don't want anything hidden in my heart. Is that the way you feel today? I want to be mature enough to deal with it. Mature enough to let Him in and we can walk there together. Praise God, and I can say I'm sorry, forgive me. You know, I just feel like right now maybe that'd be what somebody needs to do. Oh, we're all preachers here, and we're all training to be ministers and whatever. Yeah, someday you're going to stand before a congregation that needs to do exactly what we're going to do right now. Right. They need to cross the aisle, maybe, or go somewhere to your sister or your brother and say, I'm sorry. Forgive me. to do right, and I want to be right. There's nobody here today but us and God. Nobody's looking around. Close your eyes. You need to go to somebody today and say, hey, the Lord's dealing with me, and I want to be right. I want you to forgive me. Why don't you just do that right now? Step to that person and say, I'm sorry. The Lord's been too good to me to allow me to keep anything in my heart. Don't be too proud to do it. It takes a real man, a real woman to do that. Cowards won't do it. Little people won't do it. But big women who are big in Christ, who are growing in the Lord, are able to do that. So I just want you to know I love you. And I want you to forgive me. And I need the help of the Lord today. Praise God. Praise God. While nobody's looking, let the Lord deal with your heart while you're moving around. Praise God. Real Christians are those that when they have a need to do this, they'll do it. Real Christians will say, yes, I'm sorry. I just came up short somewhere, and I haven't really fulfilled what the Lord expected me, and I want to do that. I want you to forgive me. Pray for me. Praise God. Praise God. Someday you'll stand before people that need to do that. And if you will have done it at some time or other, it'll be a lot easier for you to say it, folks. You need to go to your brother, your sister, and just make it all right and clear things up so we can go on. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. going to stand in the hill of the Lord, in the mountain of God, the scripture says. They that have clean hands and a pure heart. I don't think God's trying to put out something there that's impossible to live. And I don't think he's not knowing that our frames are dust either. I think he understands that, and none of us are perfect and never will be. But I do think he would like for us to cleanse our hands and purify our hearts so that we'll be counted worthy to stand with him in that day. I certainly want to please the Lord and hear him say, well done, don't you? Praise God. Thank you, Lord, for walking among us and dealing with us. Thank you for the songs that we sung today and for the testimonies that were given. Thank you, Lord, for being merciful to us. None of us, Lord, is worthy. Not one man or woman standing here today is worthy of your blessings and is worthy really to stand with you in that holy hill. And Lord, we understand that. But we want clean hands and a pure heart, and we want to please you, and we want to do your will, and we want to be led of you, God, and we want your spirit to direct us, and we want to have good fellowship with you and with one another. Help us, Lord, to be Christians enough to, when we need to say I'm sorry and find forgiveness, and to forgive others. Help us, Lord, to be able to forgive others. For we'll never be forgiven of you unless we do. You said that, and Lord, we want to ask that very thing today. Praise God. For we want to be ready when you come again. We want to be somewhere working, somewhere serving, somewhere laboring in love, somewhere teaching children and young people and adults, somewhere counseling, somewhere preaching, somewhere on the street, somewhere in a rest home, somewhere in a home missions church. When you come again, we want you to find us somewhere working, somewhere witnessing, and somewhere serving, oh God, hallelujah, with clean hands and a pure heart and with a soul desire of serving you, winning the favor of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Help us, Lord, entertain those desires. Praise God. Brother Tim Estes, would you pray? Hallelujah.
Thank you.
digging around there, knocking on that door to get an answer. If you have your time and that was the case with you, guarantee a piece of that to me. Everybody in this building is the same name today. If there comes a time, let's deal with that. Oh, Lord, I don't want to get that away yet, my life. I'm going to give you the key. I'd open the door, and we're going to talk about that. We're going to deal with that. We're going to look at that. We're going to lock that away. Calvary's flow. It's going to be a part of the past. And you get free from that, and the fear leaves you. And you can say, Lord, in the hallway, in the room, in the soul of my heart, wherever you want to go, you're welcome. And bow it all to Jesus. We ought not to have anything if we minister the others here in our hearts. We ought not to have any room where the Lord's not welcome. We ought not to have an area that we are afraid to deal with. We ought to be acquainted with the altar. But the Paul said it well the other day about the pilgrims. We borrow an altar from the Methodist. Maybe that's not the place where sinners ought to go to receive the Holy Ghost. The theology of all of that doesn't make a lot of difference. I've seen them get the Holy Ghost beside the road. In a ditch somewhere, they just got out of a car and got down. The Father Word now filled him with the Holy Ghost. And that man that did that preaching today. Another man got down under the sawmill where he was working, down there under the basement of that old building, and he got to praying, and God filled him with the Holy Ghost there. You can get the Holy Ghost anywhere. But those altars you and I need from time to time. We need that altar. We need to go back and pray a little while and talk to God about some pain. But build up in there. So much contact with the world and jobs and people and family back home that are not sympathetic and things and money and finances and problems. Our lives get filled with that thing sometimes. And slowly and surely our walk with God erodes and our faith erodes and we just need that all. We need that place to pray. We need the messages that come from the pulpit. We need the strong preaching, and we need the Word of God to build around every old block in our lives and not in every room in our hearts. Amen. I need that. I need preaching. I need somebody to look me right in the eye and say, hey, you need to take that. You need to pray through. You need to keep thinking of your thinking. You need a new attitude. That's what they do in these pastors' institutes, and they talk to each other, and they talk to each other. They're hiring their own minister to us, and they need accountability too. Every one of them, there's not a one of us that would not need accountability to somebody. I need to be accountable. I need that. We're all accountable to the Lord, but we need accountability to each other, too. I saw the Lord bring Sister Glenda a long way in just the short years that I've known. I appreciate it. I love that song, and I think every one of us can relate to it. I'm going to sing another verse and bring it to you.
Well, I think my life, I could tell you, from the beginning, you woke up to a super church song, but I'll tell you the latest. We were having services at church up in Conway, and Brother Rodell speaking, something got a hold of my heart, and he started crying out to God, and he was talking, go to that door, go to that door. I said, Lord, hey, God, I won't be hurt again. I can't handle that. Don't hurt me again. And I ran to go to that door, and after I finished crying, I said, God, now I'm still not willing to go to hurt God. But I'm willing to carry the chip on the cross of my past and his life up here. I'm willing to help grandma, and the Lord let me make this happen. He moved me in my home. They taught me things, and now I gotta leave again, and God gave me the second chance. He said, okay, are you gonna go to the door now? And now I am, because God's taken me, He taught me, He's walked with me along the way, and I thank Him for that. Oh, open up my door, make it through the door. be a good now and then. But then one day you saw that door, and in the day had come to you soon. I said, Jesus, I'm not ready for us to visit in that room. But that's the place in my heart where even I won't go. I have to breathe in there.
Here we are at the end of the quarter now, and I wonder, are you growing? Have you grown? I want to just close your eyes a few moments, thinking back over the last 3 months. Do you know more about the Lord than you knew when you enrolled in September? Are you closer in your relationship to each other? Do you understand principles of the Word of God a little more than you do? Are you growing? Is it easier for you to say, I'm sorry, than it used to be? If it is, you're growing. Is it easier to say, forgive me? Would it be easier to wash your brother's feet, your sister's feet, than it was 3 months ago, than it would have been then? Are you learning to look at yourself with reality and truth and real honesty? If you are, you're growing. Praise God. If you're a man enough and woman enough to tell your brother or sister, I'm sorry, forgive me. The Lord put some things in my heart that make me want to and realize I need to do this. I want you to forgive me. I want to grow in Him, and I want to mature in Christ. I want to be what He has me to be. Praise God. I don't want anything hidden in my heart. Is that the way you feel today? I want to be mature enough to deal with it. Mature enough to let Him in and we can walk there together. Praise God, and I can say I'm sorry, forgive me. You know, I just feel like right now maybe that'd be what somebody needs to do. Oh, we're all preachers here, and we're all training to be ministers and whatever. Here, yeah, someday you're going to stand before a congregation that needs to do exactly what we're going to do right now. right. They need to cross the aisle, maybe, or go somewhere to your sister or your brother and say, "I'm sorry. Forgive me. I want to be right, and I want to be right." There's nobody here today but us and God. Nobody's looking around. Close your eyes. You need to go to somebody today and say, "Hey, the Lord's dealing with me, and I want to be right. I want you to forgive me." Why don't you just do that right now? Step to that person and say, "I'm sorry. The Lord's been too good to me to allow me to keep anything in my heart." Don't be too proud to do it. It takes a real man, a real woman to do that. Cowards won't do it. Little people won't do it. But big women who are big in Christ, who are growing in the Lord, are able to do that. So I just want you to know I love you. And I want you to forgive me. And I need the help of the Lord today. Praise God. Praise God. While nobody's looking, let the Lord deal with your heart while you're moving around. Praise God. Real Christians are those that when they have a need to do this, they'll do it. Real Christians will say, "Yes, I'm sorry. I just came up short somewhere, and I haven't really fulfilled what the Lord expects of me, and I want to do that. I want you to forgive me. Pray for me." Praise God. Praise God. Someday you'll stand before people that need to do that. And if you will have done it at some time or other, it'll be a lot easier for you to say it, folks. You need to go to your brother, your sister, and just make it all right and clear things up so we can go on. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. who's going to stand in the hill of the Lord, in the mountain of God, the scripture says. They that have clean hands and a pure heart. I don't think God's trying to put out something there that's impossible to live. And I don't think he's not knowing that our frames are dust either. I think he understands that, and none of us are perfect and never will be. But I do think he would like for us often to cleanse our hands and purify our hearts so that we'll be counted worthy to stand with him in that day. I certainly want to please the Lord and hear him say, well then, don't you? Praise God. Thank you, Lord, for walking among us and dealing with us. Thank you for the songs that were sung today and for the testimonies that were given. Thank you, Lord, for being merciful to us. None of us, Lord, is worthy. Not one man or woman standing here today is worthy of your blessings and is worthy really to stand with you in that holy hill. And Lord, we understand that. But we want clean hands and a pure heart, and we want to please you, and we want to do your will, and we want to be led of you, God, and we want your spirit to direct us, and we want to have good fellowship with you and with one another. Help us, Lord, to be Christians enough when we meet to say I'm sorry and find forgiveness and to forgive others. Help us, Lord, to be able to forgive others. For we'll never be forgiven of you unless we do. You said that, and Lord, we want to ask that very thing today. Praise God. Oh, we want to be ready when you come again. We want to be somewhere working, somewhere serving, somewhere laboring in love, somewhere teaching children and young people and adults, somewhere counseling, somewhere preaching, somewhere on the street, somewhere in a rest home, somewhere in a home missions church. When you come again, we want you to find us somewhere working, somewhere witnessing, and somewhere serving, oh God, hallelujah, with clean hands and a pure heart and with a soul desiring serving you and winning the favor of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Help us, Lord, entertain those desires. Praise God. Brother Tim Estes, would you pray? Hallelujah. Thank you.
afraid of the land there, knocking on that door. You don't know that. Is there ever a time when that was the case with you? I guarantee if you come back to mind, everybody in this room is the same man today. If there comes a time when you miss it, it's real. Oh, Lord, I don't want that right now. Give you the key. And open the door. And we're going to talk about that. We're going to deal with that. We're going to look at that. We're going to walk that away. Calvary's slow. It's going to be a part of the past. And you get free from that. And the fear leaves you. And you can say, Lord, in the hallway, in the room, in the soul of my heart, wherever you want to go, you're welcome. We ought not to have anything if we minister to others here in our heart. We ought not to have any room where the Lord's not welcome. We ought not to have any area that we are afraid to deal with. We ought to be acquainted with the altar. Brother Cole said it well the other day, Brother Kilgore. We borrowed altars from the Methodists. Maybe that's not the place where sinners ought to go to receive the Holy Ghost. The theology of all of that doesn't make a lot of difference. I can't get the Holy Ghost beside the road in a brick somewhere that just got out of a car and got down beside the road and filled him with the Holy Ghost. And that man that did that preaching today, another man got down into the sawmill where he was working. Down there under the basement of that old building, and he's got to pray, and God filled him with the Holy Ghost there. You can get the Holy Ghost anywhere. But those altars, you and I need from time to time. We need that altar. We need to go back and pray a little while and talk to God about some things in our heart. But build up in there. So much contact with the world and jobs and people and family back home that are not sympathetic and things and money and finances and problems. Our lives get filled with that thing sometimes. And slowly and surely I walk with God, He rolls and I say He rolls, and we just need that altar. We need that place to pray. We need the messages that come from the pulpit. We need the strong preaching, and we need the Word of God to dig around every roadblock in our lives. And that's what we need. Amen. I need that. I need preaching. I need somebody to look me right in the eye and say, hey, you need to take up. You need to pray through. You need to do right. You need to keep thinking about your thinking. You need a new attitude. What they do in these pastors' institutes, and they talk to each other, and they talk to each other. They're hiring their own to minister to us, and they need accountability too. Every one of them, there's not a one of us that would not need accountability to somebody. I need to be accountable. I need that. We're all accountable to the Lord, but we need accountability to each other too. I saw the Lord bring people down by a long way. In just the short years that I've known, I appreciate it. I love that song, and I think every one of us can relate to it. I'm going to sing another verse and sing it to
you. I think, if I could tell you, from the beginning, we woke up to a super church on Sunday. I'll tell you the ladies, we were having services at church at the family, and Brother Rodell's preaching, something got a hold of my heart, and I started crying out to God, and he was talking, go to that door, go to that door. I said, Lord, hey, God. I won't be hurt again. I can't handle this. Don't hurt me again. And I ran to get to that door, and after I finished praying, I said, God, now I'm still not willing to go to hurt God. But I'm willing to carry the trip on the cross of my pastor and his wife up here. I'm willing to help women. And the Lord let an issue happen, heart to heart, when all at the same time, then in reason, we would be good men then. But then one day we saw that door, and even though it can't be seen, I said, Jesus, I'm not ready for us to go to the night.
Here we are at the end of the quarter now, and I wonder, are you growing? Have you grown? Why don't you just close your eyes a few moments, thinking back over the last 3 months. Do you know more about the Lord than you knew when you enrolled in September? Are you closer in your relationship to each other? Do you understand principles of the Word of God a little more than you do? Are you growing? Is it easier for you to say I'm sorry than it used to be? But here you're growing. Is it easier to say forgive me? Would it be easier to wash your brother's feet, your sister's feet than it was 3 months ago than it would have been then? Are you learning to look at yourself with reality and truth and real honesty? If you are, you're growing. Praise God. If you're a man enough and woman enough to tell your brother or sister, I'm sorry, forgive me. The Lord put some things in my heart that make me want to realize I need to do this. I want you to forgive me. I want to grow in Him, and I want to mature in Christ. I want to be what He has me to be. Praise God. I don't want anything hidden in my heart. Is that the way you feel today? I want to be mature enough to deal with it. Mature enough to let Him in and be more so together. Praise God, and I can say I'm sorry, forgive me. You know, I just feel like right now maybe that'd be what somebody needs to do. oh, we're all preachers here, and we're all training to be ministers and whatever. Yeah, someday you're going to stand before a congregation that needs to do exactly what we're going to do right now. Right. They need to cross the aisle, maybe, or go somewhere to your sister or your brother and say, oh, I'm sorry. Forgive me. I want to be right, and I want to be right. There's nobody here today but us, God. Nobody's looking around. Close your eyes. You need to go to somebody today and say, hey, the Lord's dealing with me, and I want to be right. I want you to forgive me. Why don't you just do that right now? Step to that person and say, I'm sorry. The Lord's been too good to me to allow me to keep anything in my heart. Don't be too proud to do it. It takes a real man, a real woman to do that. Cowards won't do it. Little people won't do it. But big women who are big in Christ, who are growing in the Lord, are able to do that. So I just want you to know I love you. And I want you to forgive me. And I need the help of the Lord today. Praise God. Praise God. While nobody's looking, let the Lord deal with your heart while you're moving around. Praise God. Real Christians are those that when they have a need to do this, they'll do it. Real Christians will say, yes, I'm sorry. I just came up short somewhere, and I haven't really fulfilled what the Lord expects of me, and I want to do that. I want you to forgive me. Pray for me. Praise God. Praise God. Someday you'll stand before people that need to do that. And if you will have done it at some time or other, it'll be a lot easier for you to say it, folks. You need to go to your brother or your sister and just make it all right and clear things up so we can go on. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Desire in our hearts,
he's going to stand in the hill of the Lord, in the mountain of God, the scripture says. They that have clean hands and a pure heart. I don't think God's trying to put out something there that's impossible to live. And I don't think he's not knowing that our frames are dust either. I think he understands that, and none of us are perfect and never will be. But I do think he would like for us and to cleanse our hands and purify our hearts so that we'll be counted worthy to stand with him in that day. I certainly want to please the Lord and hear him say the other day. Praise God. Thank you, Lord, for walking among us and dealing with us. Thank you for the songs that we sung today and for the testimonies that were given. Thank you, Lord, for being merciful to us. None of us, Lord, is worthy. Not one man or woman standing here today is worthy of your blessings and is worthy really to stand with you in that holy hill. And Lord, we understand that. But we want clean hands and a pure heart, and we want to please you, and we want to do your will, and we want to be led of you, God, and we want your spirit to direct us, and we want to have good fellowship with you and with one another. Help us, Lord, to be Christians enough to, when we need to say I'm sorry and find forgiveness, and to forgive others. Help us, Lord, to be able to forgive others. For we'll never be forgiven of you unless we do. You said that, and Lord, we want to ask that very thing today. Praise God. For we want to be ready when you come again. We want to be somewhere working, somewhere serving, somewhere laboring in love, somewhere teaching children and young people and adults, somewhere counseling, somewhere preaching, somewhere on the street, somewhere in a rest home, somewhere in a home mission church. When you come again, we want you to find us somewhere working, somewhere witnessing, and somewhere serving, oh God. Hallelujah. With clean hands and a pure heart and with a soul desiring serving you, winning the favor of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us, Lord, entertain those desires. Praise God. Brother Tim, would you pray? Hallelujah.